So, in a couple of previous videos, I've spoken about tanmatras, subtle elements, and mahat, cosmic intelligence. And I want to somehow see if we can relate this to modern scientific ideas, such as quantum constructs and cosmological principles. Is there a shared focus on the fundamental building blocks and the entanglement of what we call reality? So let's address tanmatras and quantum constructs. So tanmatras, Sanskrit word, are described as subtle energies or potentials of experience. Subtle energies or potentials for experience, such as sound, touch, form, taste, smell, which then manifest into the physical world through interaction with the gross elements, which are referred to as the Mahabhutas, space, air, fire, water, earth. So what I'm saying resonates with the concept of quantum fields in physics, where particles arise as excitations of underlying fields. And so just as tanmatras are non-physical, yet foundations to sensory experience. Okay, you want to experience a tanmatra? Think of a sound, any sound, a bell. Think of a flavor, any flavor. Strawberries. Think of any sensation, touching the rough bark of a tree. So tanmatras are thought forms, and they linked to the physical form. So just as tanmatras are foundational to sensory experience, quantum wave functions represent probabilities rather than tangible entities until observed. Also, tanmatras of vibrational nature. The vibrational essence of tanmatras aligns with wave-particle duality in quantum mechanics. Matter and energy exhibit both particle-like and wave-like behavior depending on observation, much like how subtle energies transform into gross elements through interaction. Then, of course, something that I've mentioned many times, non-locality, quantum entanglement, where particles remain interconnected or entangled regardless of distance, mirrors the interconnectedness of tanmatras within the unified field of consciousness. Example, think of your favorite food, or think of what you had to eat for dinner last night. And as you think of that, then images crop up. Like, who were you with? What were the emotions being experienced? What was the music in the background? So, just one experience connects with every other experience. So, those are, of course, the wave-like probabilities of experience in the tanmatras, but actually very similar to quantum entanglement. Now look at Mahat, which is cosmic intelligence or consciousness, as a unifying principle. This is considered the first ripple of awareness in equilibrium, the most ordered state, supersymmetry. And that is an aspect of Purusha, pure consciousness. And then it manifests as Prakriti. It represents the manifest nature of reality, the organizing principle behind creation. This parallels modern cosmology's search for a theory of everything that unifies fundamental forces like gravity, electromagnetism, and quantum mechanics. And all this emerges from a state of perfect order, perfect equilibrium, supersymmetry. In Indian cosmology, Mahat arises when the equilibrium of the three gunas. Gunas are qualities. Sattva, which is creativity, rajas, which is transformation, tamas, which is inertia. When this perfect equilibrium of these qualities is disturbed. And similarly, modern cosmology describes the universe's emergence from a highly symmetric state during the Big Bang, where symmetry breaking led to the formation of space-time and matter. So, ancient philosophies view Mahat as pervading all phenomena and serving as the foundation for space-time creation. And this idea finds echoes in theories like quantum cosmology, where consciousness or observation plays a role in collapsing wave functions to define reality. So let's bridge these two ideas, ancient and modern. The parallel between these concepts suggests that ancient Indian cosmology anticipated ideas central to modern science. Both systems propose that reality emerges from subtle, non-material potentials. Superposition of possibilities of experience. They emphasize interconnectedness, whether through quantum entanglement or the unity of consciousness. And both East-West ideas recognize that space-time is not absolute, but arises from deeper principles. So while ancient philosophies use a different language of consciousness and modern science relies on empirical methods, their shared goal is understanding the origins and structure of the universe. And this convergence highlights how ancient wisdom can complement modern scientific exploration. But there's more here because the tanmatras and cosmic intelligence are available to us as we trace any experience to its source, which is outside of space-time. And by transcending to that source and then focusing intently on an intended outcome, taking it through meditation, into samadhi, subject-object split is resolved, you begin to actually influence the fabric of space-time. I have a course coming up on this. It's called an advanced meditation. Stay tuned and I will be announcing it soon. Thank you and enjoy playing in this cosmic playground, which has its origins in yourself, the self of the individual, also the self of the universe. I love sharing these ideas with you. Let me know if I should continue. Thank you so much.